Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, compliments of the Christmas season. And in this special Christmas lesson, we are going to look at one of the greatest Christmas tunes we'll have, Joy to the World. And I'm going to give you a very interesting solo piano arrangement, which sounds more like a folk music arrangement with a very interesting rhythm pattern, which I think you can use for not only this song, but a lot of other songs as well, be it Christmas songs or anything else. So the main intention in the lesson is to show you the melody of the song, which I'm sure you may already know, but I'll anyways revise that with you, and also give you the pattern. It's going to be a very, very sort of iconic rhythm pattern which I'm going to be teaching you, which can be used for ballad music, for folk music, for pop music, and a lot of things, and obviously for Joy to the World, which we are going to learn in this lesson. So I'm taking the scale of D major for our study. So we're going to do the entire song on D major. Okay, and the chords are very, very simple for Joy to the World. It's just pretty much D major, G major here and there, A major here and there, occasional B minor. That's pretty much it. Actually, I added the B minor. I don't think the original has it. But the chords are not so much important for the lesson. What's more important is the pattern, the independence, and getting the melody with the pattern in order to maybe not play a rendition which feels like this. And then some piano students or some learners would then play chords in the left. You know? But there's no groove, there's no pattern there. And that's where I think this lesson will help you. The lesson is supplemented by a downloadable PDF with all the notation for the song. And what's also cool, which we have for you or in store for you, will be MIDI files. Now, while preparing this version, I also figured that there could be a lot of other versions for Joy to the World in this style or in this avatar, you know. So I have recorded all of those, and for timing, otherwise this lesson would be like an hour long possibly, I have recorded those as a MIDI file for you to go through, and you can import into any MIDI playback software which will play back with the notation, with the piano playing as well. And we also will have a video of that in this chapter. So for that, you need to head over to patreon.com, support the channel for just a sum of about $5 a month, and you will get yourself copies of the notation. And this is not just the only Christmas lesson. We'll be talking about a few more over the month. So do stay tuned, and let's get started with the tutorial. So let's discuss the melody line of Joy to the World. I'm sure you guys already know it, but nevertheless, super easy. Let's do it. First line, well, it's just the descending scale. Joy to the World, the Lord is come. So you just go, Joy to the World, the Lord is come. So you just go down, and however you're taught D major descending, it's just five fingers, cross over your middle finger, in the Joy to the World iconic rhythm. That the rhythm is a very important part of the melody. Melody is just not the notes, it's the way the notes are timed. That's what I keep saying in all my videos. So you go, okay, one more time, Joy to the World, the Lord has come. And now let earth, you're gonna end at king here. Let earth receive her king. You'll be ending here with your pinky. In order to do that, you don't want to cross your ring and pinky. It would be very difficult, and you may wish you had more fingers, which clearly you're not going to get. So you go, cross the index finger there. Let earth receive her king. Two lines. And now index, middle, ring. You could also keep this D ringing, which I tend to do very often, because the root of the song, it'll sound good with pretty much everything. So could do that. It just works with everything. So I tend to do that sometimes. Okay, let's do the next two lines, which is let every heart prepare him room. It's quite easy because both the lines are the same melody.
Let every heart prepare him room.
You need to repeat a couple of those notes. So the fingers, some notes are repeated. Let every heart prepare him room. Okay, so far we have. Next line. Okay, and now. Now your index finger is already here, so you could probably just continue with the index.
Heaven and nature sing, let heaven and nature sing.
Let heaven and nature. Okay, at least that's how I remember the tune.
Let heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
You could do nature sing or nature sing. There are various renditions of it, so you could figure that out.
Let heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
And then try to cross your middle finger there.
And heaven.
And then pinky to hit the octave.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing.
Let's do the last line.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing.
Let's do the whole melody again. Try to follow along. Look at the notation as well. That could also be very helpful if you read. Otherwise, just follow along and go with your ear. That should be more than enough.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive a king.
Wait.
Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and heaven and nature sing.
So that's the melody. Hope you have fun with that. But on the piano, you're not going to get away with playing the melody. If someone comes home for Christmas and tells you, play Joy to the World, and if you're a flautist or a violinist or a trumpet player, people are going to say, wow, this guy is awesome. How beautiful sounding is that? But on a piano, you cannot survive with the melody in one hand. So that's where the next part of the lesson is, with the left hand production. Okay, now I'm going to build the left hand in two stages. First off, I will give you the rhythm pattern, which is the root and the fifth. If you're a beginner, you can perhaps look at the melody with just that pattern throughout the piece, and it could work quite well for you. So that would go. Let me play it and then show you. So it's 1-5-5-1-5-5-1-5-5. Okay, and 1 and 2. And so it's come the fifth with my thumb is coming in at the and beats. 1 and 2 and 3. 1 and 2 and. Okay. And you could even hold on your pedal. Sounds quite nice. Or without the pedal also sounds quite nice. You get a nice staccato flavor. So this needs to first be practiced with the melody. Song. It's a folk song, so it works well. So that's the rhythm. Try to keep that rhythm to kind of become like almost involuntary. It's just kind of happens. See, another way to practice it is chat with a few folks at home, or read a book or something, or cook some food. For that you have to take the piano to the kitchen, which may be an interesting thing to do. So basically practice getting a hold or a grip of this rhythm quite subconsciously. Talk to someone about your day or whatever you want. If you can do that, if you can isolate your brain, your conscious brain from this rhythm, then you can do anything. Okay, so this is the bass. So now I'm just going to color up this in this entire lesson, and that's all you have to learn. And you can apply how many ever colors there were discussed in this tutorial for your production. But to be honest, I think it doesn't sound too bad with just the root and the fifth. As we say in India, sa and the pa, right?
Sa pa, pa sa pa, pa sa pa.
But the challenge is to line up this rhythm with the melody. And the Joy to the World melody is a folk melody. It's not a very classically composed melody where the beats are very fixed. There's a lot of 16th notes. There's a lot of dotted notes, as we call them in Western notation. So it'll be quite a hurdle or quite a challenge, quite an interesting job to try and get that melody with the bass line. Now coming to coloring it up. First of all, I have a nice intro for you. You go. Okay, you could go D, A, A, D, A, A, D. I'm opening up the harmony like a G major. D, G, B, D, G. You can kind of climb there to an A major with an E on the bass. So it's gonna take us to the melody, and now we start. And now begins. Now there are little things I do, like in the first line,
joy to the world, the Lord.
So I'm trying to imagine like a tenor voice in a choir to try and do that, and I'm trying to line that up in the same rhythm pretty much, but instead of doing A, that's not a very creative tenor. The tenor would go,
the Lord has come.
So just get a little bit of that essence in your left hand thumb. I know it's a bit unconventional, it's not a choral way of playing it, but you still get the same harmony, which I think is fine. Let's do the whole thing again, the tenor. Okay.
B, A, G, F sharp, A, D.
I'm still holding on to those off beats so that the groove is still maintained. Again. Okay, let's proceed. Now what did I do there? I think the chords in general are
let earth, which is G major, receive
A major,
a king.
That's a very nice cadence. It's like a 4 going to 5 going to 1. Very powerful classical cadence. So
let earth receive a king.
That's a 4 going to 5 going to 1. So how did I play that? If you'd like, if you still like that tenor,
let earth receive a king.
The soprano is doing
let earth receive a king.
So you could actually do two notes on the piano. I've kind of freed up your hand to do two notes because the next note is kind of covered here in the bass. So
let earth,
G, A, back. Let's do that line. If you can't do the tenor and the right, no problem. Just sounds a bit more harmonically rich. Shall we move on? Okay, so first two lines. Groovy tenor, which goes a little bit differently in the shape compared to the soprano. Let's do that slowly. Little bit of independence here, which I think is fun.
Three heart.
let every heart.
Let every heart prepare.
Only let every heart. Now for the same melody repeats for prepare him room.
Let every heart prepare him room.
I just thought we can elevate it there with some new chords.
Prepare him room.
What did I do there? B minor with just a single B. With a nice octave. Could even stack up the soprano there with more flavor with the root and the five. Come back. Let's do that, both those two lines.
Every heart preparing.
Slower. Okay. Also, stay tuned till the end. I'll play you the entire version slowly. Another reminder that there is this entire notation waiting for you on our Patreon. Do head over there and you will get yourself a copy, and not just for this lesson, pretty much any lesson we will ever do is on Patreon waiting for you there. Okay, so that part. So now normally you would have played it like this, right? Chords are different though, so we go
and human nature sing.
I quite like that. I'm following my soprano.
Heaven and nature sing,
right?
Heaven and nature sing.
It's like a bass part or a lower alto, you could say.
And heaven and nature sing.
And you always come back to that rhythm. Okay, on the piano. It's a very piano rhythm. It's something which very few people on other instruments do. So, as a piano arrangement, it's very essential to give us that piano rhythm, that unique piano color, right? Otherwise, you could play it in a choral way. It sounds very grand, but this is what a piano player could perhaps do, you know, over the track. And then you could have people singing over it as well, because you are covering up the harmony. So let's do that again.
And heaven and nature sing.
Now the other end, heaven and nature sing.
And first one. And heaven.
That's A. I'm taking A major there.
Heaven and nature sing.
I'm climbing my bass. So
heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
That's like a G over B and an A over C sharp. Slash chords make things very uplifting, if you ask me. So
heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature.
Okay, last line now, folks. I'm giving like a nice dyad there. So just to do something different, which we didn't yet do. So play G over B and F sharp with A together. Okay, get that offbeat A as well. Nature sing, the very end. There's a little bit of a stretch. If you're a younger player or if you have smaller fingers, you could replace G with B. I kind of like G there, so
nature sing.
I like that ending tenor. So thing. Okay, let's just do the last line.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing.
And you could repeat. Now, if you're an intermediate player, I'm going to leave some MIDI files where you can exactly see what I'm doing. There'll be a video also for that. And it'll be a little bit easier for you to just watch me play rather than me try to talk about everything, because an intermediate advanced version may have a lot of ingredients rhythmically and harmonically. So all that is waiting for you on the Patreon. Apart from the notation, a lot of things are there regarding this song. So head over to Patreon if possible. Let me now conclude the lesson, guys, by playing the entire thing slowly. Try to follow along if you can. And if you are finding it difficult in the initial stages, just learn it as it is. I've talked to you about the simplified version, and just give it a couple of days, right? And hopefully it's not going to be too late for Christmas, because I would encourage you to perform this for your friends, family, share it on your social media as well before Christmas. So the time is ticking, or the clock is ticking. So work at it, work hard, but relax and play. Do it at a skill level which you can do. I hope I've conveyed this for at least a few skill levels in this rendition. So let me conclude the lesson by playing Joy to the World solo piano arrangement slowly. And it'll be great if you haven't already to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon for regular notifications. Follow us on Instagram or Facebook. You can also visit our website for a lot of lessons, courses, which are catalogued really efficiently well now with tags and so on. You could also do a course, a full-on course, a four-month full-length course at whichever level, be it foundation or intermediate or advanced, for all the instruments we cover at our music school, including vocals, by the way. So let's get cracking with a slow version, and thanks a ton for watching the lesson.